ma'am, you all right? Ma'am, you okay? There's no response. Go ahead and we're going to call a code, or you in the plaid shirt, go call 911, get an AED and bring it back. I'm going to assess the pulse. I'm checking for any normal signs of breathing.
Yeah, I don't see any breathing.
She has a good pulse, but she's not breathing. Yeah. Go ahead and provide ventilations, please.
Okay.
I'm going to go ahead and get the naloxone kit prepared because I do believe this is an opioid or opiate overdose.
Okay.
I'm ready anytime you're ready there.
Okay, one more breath and go ahead.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and provide 1 milliliter of the left nostril. Same for the other nostril. Okay, go ahead and continue breathing.
Okay.
Good. Looks like she still has a pretty good pulse there.
Yeah.
Breaths are going in well.
Yeah. Kind of looks like she's starting to take breaths on her own now.
Is she? Okay.
Yeah. Kind of fighting up.
No, ma'am. It's okay, ma'am. Ma'am, it's okay. We're here to help. It's okay.
We're going to take good care of you, ma'am. Just try to relax. Opiates and opioids are central nervous system, or CNS, depressants. The CNS controls our ability to breathe and keep our heart beating. And when depressed too far by CNS depressants, these functions can slow down and eventually stop. Most people think that only addicts and illegal drug users can overdose on opiates or opioids. And it is true that most people who are addicted suffer the most overdoses. However, anyone taking them can suffer opiate or opioid overdose, especially when they take more than was prescribed by the doctor, or they combine opiates and opioids with other CNS depressants, or they have an unknown condition that makes them more sensitive to overdose. A few common opiates and opioids include heroin, morphine, codeine, methadone, hydrocodone known as Vicodin or Lortab, and oxycodone, otherwise known as Percocet. Common drugs that may cause similar signs but are not opioids or opiates are cocaine, LSD, ecstasy, tranquilizers, and marijuana. Naloxone will have no real effect on non-opioid or opiate drugs. And while you can't be certain of an opiate or opioid overdose, some signs should make you suspect that there's a problem, like bottles of drugs nearby the patient, or a very slow respiratory rate, or even pinpoint pupils. For a patient with known or suspected opioid addiction, appropriately trained lay rescuers or healthcare providers should administer intramuscular or intranasal naloxone, if available, per their protocol. A naloxone dose of 2 milligrams is what's recommended for rapid reversal when respiratory compromise is present. Naloxone typically takes 3 to 5 minutes for the full effect. The duration of action for naloxone is shorter than that of most opioids, so patients must be closely monitored for reoccurrence of problems when the effects of the naloxone wear off. Additional doses may be necessary to maintain reversal. It's been recommended that patients who receive naloxone are still observed for a minimum of 2 hours after the last dose. And in the case of a person who you suspect has an opiate or opioid overdose that is not breathing normally, lay rescuers should start CPR and a healthcare provider should check for a pulse to determine whether or not to start rescue breathing or full CPR. To administer naloxone, assemble the nasal atomizer. Tilt the head back and briskly spray half of the naloxone up one side of the nose, that of about 1 cc, and half up the other side of the nose, which will equal 1 cc. The idea is to atomize the naloxone into a fine mist. Rescue breathing or CPR should continue while waiting for the naloxone to take effect. If there's no change in 3 to 5 minutes, administer another dose of naloxone and continue CPR or rescue breathing. If the second dose of naloxone doesn't revive them, something else is wrong. Either there are no opioids in their system, or the opioids are unusually strong and require more naloxone.